Play action here on first down. Looking left side, and it's complete. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. That is catch number 300 now for his NFL career. Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. A first carry for Najee Harris. And he's going to take this one up only to about the 44-yard line. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine. Beal. And that nearly an interception here on this opening drive, but he gets a reprieve. It's third down. He was all over that route defensively. Now, they had two picks last week as a unit. Couldn't quite grab that one.
Patience, Grasshopper. Patience. It's early in this game, but you like the fact that they're around the football early. They're going to be upset they didn't haul that one in, but at least they're there at the moment of truth to make a play on it.
By the way, where did the Grasshopper thing come from? I know it's been around for a long time.
Yeah, you know, I'll have to tell you that some other time.
All right, back to football. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Trayvon Diggs. And the Cowboys are going to get possession here as they force the opening drive turnover. Starting position for the Cowboys here as they come up first and 10 at the 40. To throw is Rush. This one goes out wide for Barkley. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield.
And I like the idea here. Get the ball in his hands, even if it's in the passing game. Three catches a week ago, and he does a nice job here to pick up yardage.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw to Barkley on the check down. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30.
I'm not sure that this play was designed for him specifically, but they got through the progressions and got the ball to him. So second catch on the drive, he may not be a primary guy, but they definitely want him involved, don't they?
Absolutely. This early, the opening drive, as you said, two catches. So if they can get him going in the passing game, that should open up his running game too. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. On the ground, this is Saquon Barkley. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. This offense, Charles, we've talked about how well they played all season, sitting now at 13-0 and the finish line for a perfect regular season. That's in sight. Some in the media this week were pointing back to the 07 Patriots. Of course, remember, they finished the regular season unbeaten, but they were tested multiple times in that final month plus.
Yeah, with something like 4 of their last 6 wins were one-possession games, and they played like a team that was trying to protect something instead of chasing something. And that's what happens when you have an undefeated record. So it behooves you as a team, get a couple blowouts in there so you get a chance to relax and breathe. But that's much easier said than done.
Here we go.
on second and a yard. Rush. He dumps it off to Barkley. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
Counting down toward the midway point in quarter one. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Forced out to his left. He finds his man, complete. That's Bennett. And the Cowboys are going to have a first and goal coming up as the tackle made at the 3-yard line. Late in the season now, MVP chatter starts, and he might be on the fringe. This is always an award that goes quarterback, running back, usually quarterback.
Against him.
A lot of bias. Does he deserve consideration?
He more than deserves consideration because the way the game is played in the NFL now, it's a pass-first league, right? So that means that people are going to adjust their defenses for him each and every week, and he's still putting up big-time numbers. I know the quarterbacks, the running backs get it, but he should be firmly in the race for MVP.
And he pushes forward but comes up short of the goal line as he'll get a yard down to about the one.
It is definitely hard to find space near the goal line. You always want to have a guy in the game running it who can create his own.
And Barkley will try to punch it in. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of two, now third down.
You can almost feel him thinking as he's running the football, just one more block, anything to get me to the perimeter and around the corner. Couldn't quite get there, ends up getting spilled for a loss.
Here's Barkley. No gain on the play that time. So a big stop, and it's going to leave him with a fourth and goal. Defense didn't budge on third down. Now what are we going to see on fourth?
We are soon to find out, but does this feel like old school football or what?
Oh,
right?
Yeah.
This is an old-fashioned goal line stand. I know what I would call on offense. I would go for it. And I want some type of a play where my quarterback has a chance to run it or throw it. I don't just want one static play.
And no hesitation about this decision here. Confidently, they're going to go for this. Fourth and goal from the three. They get this out left. And that is caught. Touchdown, Cowboys. A great play there. His 17th touchdown now on the season. And the Cowboys have taken the early lead. And his kick is no good. An inauspicious start here kicking-wise as this one stays a 6-0 game. So with a missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Bucks offense set to begin their next possession. And Charles, you look at these two teams, and these are those kind of litmus test games in the second half of the season that if you're a coach or a player, you can either really look forward to them or really dread them, depending on your point of view.
And if you're dreading them, you're not going to go very far in the playoffs. You need to look forward to these kind of games because here we've got two division leaders, both real contenders for the NFC title. And you're right, you love having easy games on your schedule, but you need some games like this to toughen you up a bit and ensure that you're ready for the shock of playoff football.
They'll come up now second and four from the 31. They'll try the right side with Harris. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. He was solid last week, over 100 yards in their victory on the ground. They want to get that going again.
Absolutely. What they also understand is that from week to week, it's not necessarily the same, but they want it to be, right? What they saw last week on the ground, they want to see in this game as well.
Now a first down carry for Harris. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. 6-0 our score after one. The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. Now a give right side. Harris. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50.
Even though they gave up more than they wanted to on that play, it actually illustrates how well they bottled him up throughout the game, because that was his longest run of this contest.
They'll run on first down. Harris. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
With his size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
So the first down run lost a couple. Now they come up second and 12. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. Trying for Brown, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Trayvon Diggs. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Cowboy defense has a touchdown. Now Tucker to add the PAT. And he atones for his miss the first time around, as this one is up and good to extend their lead. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. Hines opting not to risk it, and this will come out to the 25. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And they just had that pick six. I guess the only positive maybe of them returning that for a touchdown, this offense right back out onto the field to try to make up for it.
I like that, because now it doesn't give them a chance to go to the bench and really settle. You know, to sit there and kind of seethe over the idea that they turned the ball over previously. Right back out there, it's almost like hopping right back on the bike after falling over. See if they can get the ball moving again.
Yeah, we'll see if they can do it here. A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. A run with Harris out of the shotgun. And it worked his way across the 30 to the 32. Trying to pick it up on the ground with Harris. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line.
That's about what you would expect, since they're so efficient at picking up third downs in the top five in the NFL. It's all a mindset, and I guarantee you, it started in the offseason. Third down's important to them. They find a way to pick them up at a very good clip.
On first down, it's Harris. And able to get this one all the way up to about the 46-yard line. 45 yards on the ground for him so far.
Hey, when you get good yardage like that on first down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
On second down, this is Harris. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so now third down coming up. On third down, here's Harris. And this one's going to go the wrong way, losing yardage back at the 42. Defensively, they rallied the troops to force fourth down after that 7-yard pickup back on first. So it looks like the offense isn't going anywhere. They're going to go for it on fourth and 7. They'll try and throw for it here. Able to find Isabella. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Both sides were holding their breath there on that fourth down play, and the offense can breathe a sigh of relief.
And both knew exactly where the first down markers were. You know the defense is trying to guard those sticks and try and keep people in front. But somehow, some way, those guys...
And oh, his first carry, he loses the football. It's picked up by the Cowboys. He's at the 40, past the 20. And he is not quite going to make it all the way in. They'll mark him down right about the 1-yard line. And now, as with every potential turnover, they're going to take a second look at this just to make sure. So that one overturned. They say the knee was down, and that will not be ruled a fumble. The fumble on first down. Now here's second down. They hand this off to Harris. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Now they're going to be dealing with a 3rd and 7. Is that one officially a loss of 1?
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively, because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event,
and for the 3rd time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by Micah Parsons. And now off to the races down the right side. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Cowboy defense has a touchdown. And remember, this is the number one defense in the National Football League. There's a good example of why.
Shows that they set an aggressive tone, not just stopping the run, not just getting after the quarterback, but the ball's in the air. They treat it like they're the receivers, and they went after that one and took it all the way.
So they throw the pick 6. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And no thought of a return here for Hines. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And with a little under a minute remaining, they may try to put something together here just to try to cut into that deficit. He'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31. The last run got 6, now 2nd and 4. And obviously not fooling anybody here as they stop him behind the line of scrimmage.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result, negative yardage. On 3rd down, it's Harris across the 30 to the 31-yard line. It's a gain of just 3, and the offense likely going to yield to the punting unit here on 4th down.
But this was just simply excellent defense. On this 3rd down, they had to be alert for the possibility of a pass, but that didn't stop them at all from understanding what was going on when they decided to run the football, and they just swarmed and stuffed them for almost no gain.
And this offense has converted twice already here in this first half on 4th down conversions. And here we go again. They're going for it. This is Harris. And boy, this is going to be close. That mark looks a little short, and he didn't get there. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And that will force a turnover on downs. From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10. Slam, slam, slam. throwing here. Rush. Throw left side complete. That's Bennett. But he's down inside the five at the four before he's out of bounds. A big connection on that one. 30 yards. Here's first and goal, and gosh, points here. A chance maybe to put this thing away before halftime. Here's Rush to throw. And the stop will come inside the five at the four. The Cowboys signal for their third and final timeout, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. Second and goal from inside the five. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Speed is the name of the game when it comes to RPOs, and sometimes you can be a little too quick, thus inaccurate, incomplete.
A chance to really put this game out of reach. Here's third and goal. Timeouts, remember, so this is going to have to be a delay. And that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves him back five. How crucial will those 5 yards be? We'll see as they come up again here, third and goal. Now Rush. That's into a crowd and intercepted. Picked off by Caleb Farley. It's a pick six. He brings it back to the house for a Buccaneer TD. You think you're going into halftime with a good-sized lead? Not so fast. That pick six really changes the complexion, probably also changes the halftime speech.
No doubt about it. Instead of going in relaxed, you're probably a little more uptight right now, probably a little bit angry. Let's see if they can get their focus back.
Extra point by Bass, up and good. And they're able to cut this deficit down to 12. So we have come to halftime here in Dallas with the Cowboys out in front, as we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. The Cowboys will get the football first here, and they have the lead as well as we are underway in quarter three. And the half will begin with a touchback. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. Rush. Being chased out left. It won't be a sack, but it's no gain, and it brings up second down.
And while he did a good job of sliding around in the pocket, there was nowhere to go with the football, so he had to take off and try and run. He just got back to the line of scrimmage, no gain.
Second down, here's Barkley. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
to throw rush. Out to his left. And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down.
We just saw a nice example of why teams often bring in baseball guys to teach quarterbacks how to slide in key situations. You want to protect your franchise guy. Make sure he doesn't get hurt. He did exactly that on that play. A perfect slide to avoid the big hit and pick up a first down.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Off the play fake. Rush. Caught left side. Bennett. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. That's the number two receiver in the NFL in terms of yardage. And tell you what, a few more plays like that, he won't be number two for long.
Well, that's what often happens when you have competitors running around the field. These guys know where they stand in relationship to yardage, totals, numbers, the whole deal. And let's face it, all of them, they all want to be number one.
So from Buccaneer territory now, it's first and 10 at the 46. Back to throw. Rush. James has got it. Complete. A good rally to the football keeps him to only a yard, and it's second down.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
Now it's second and 9. They go back to the ground now with Barkley. And some good tackling there as he stopped up at about the 41. And now on third down, they'll need to get it to the 36 to pick up the first. On the move to his left. That's caught by his tight end, Dawson Knox. And he's going to be out down inside the 20 at the 15.
Now that's all about making something happen as a quarterback, because instead of forcing something on third down, how about him buying some time outside of the pocket, waiting for someone to come open? And when he did, he put it on him for a big play and a first down.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. Now with just 1 second showing on the play clock, we're going to get a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. Handoff to Barkley, and they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
Unable to hold on to that defensively. A potential game changer, but it falls incomplete.
In any event, it happened pretty quickly. I'm not sure he made the right decision on that one. I think if he had it to do over again, he would have found a different target downfield. But he made his decision, And that one's incomplete.
On third down, Barkley. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. A nice run leaves him just inches from a first. Could they possibly be tempted to try this on fourth and about a foot? They'll run for it with Barkley. And he will have the first down before he's brought down at the three. Just enough push up front. He only needed about 6 inches. He didn't get a whole lot more than that.
No, but he made sure he got enough so they didn't have to worry about measuring it or making it even close. Ends up picking up a couple of yards in a situation, as you noted, where he only needed inches.
Try and run for it on first and goal. And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. A great effort there. His fourth touchdown on the year. And the Cowboys take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. Tucker with the extra point, and that will make this a 19-point game. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And they're going to mark that where it went out of bounds. So really good starting field position up past the 40-yard line. Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at their own 42. On the give, this is Harris, and not much there at all. Maybe a yard up to the 43. And Charles, you look at this defense, yeah, they're a confident bunch, and they're going to need to be. They're facing a group here that is seeking a fifth consecutive victory.
And this head coach knows all about motivational tactics. He was touting his unit all week, saying, we've got a locker room full of guys ready to step up, ready to go, and he believes that.
Harris going to get it again on second down. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of a yard, so it's back to third and 10.
You got to figure the further they fall behind, the more you think that they'll get away from the run. They're trying to stick with it, but the results, they just aren't there.
One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. A third down now. Those last two plays indicative of how things have gone for them. Just nowhere to go on the ground and struggling to put up points. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down. So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10, down at the 33. Operating from the gun, Beal. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. A give to Harris. He'll get forward for three down to the 16-yard line. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Looking to throw. Beal. That swung out wide to Harris. And he will reach the 5-yard line before going out of bounds.
This defense has certainly had an outstanding second half, haven't they? I know they just gave up a first down there, and for the offense, they're hoping that that's something that they can jumpstart with and maybe start to move the ball a little bit better. But it's been tough sledding for them here the entire second half.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he's going to get him about 3 yards closer. He's down to about the 2. Looking to throw on second down. Beal. And he's got it. Caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Najee Harris. Touchdown number 18 on the year. And the Bucs have got it back to a two-score game here in the fourth. Extra point by Bass, up and good. And they're able to cut this deficit down to 12. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. Looking up into the lights, and he muffs it. And there will not be a return here. It's a touchback, and it'll come out to the 25-yard line. Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. Now there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away, first downs, they can't touch the ball.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. They'll go to Barkley again. Barkley, a first down and more. There he goes, left side. Touchdown, Cowboys. Well, we've had some great running backs in the NFL the last decade or so, and Saquon Barkley might be among the smoothest of them all. What a heck of a run right there. And oh, he clanks it off the right upright, and it's no good. Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. Hines opting not to risk it, and this will come out to the 25. Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And their four-game win streak very much in jeopardy as they go to work here late with a first and 10. They'll start the drive with Harris. And he'll manage to pick up about 4. It's second down. The run got 4. Now they deal with a second and 6. Back to throw. Beal. Harris has it over the middle. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Looking to throw. Beal escaping the pressure right. That's caught by Howard. A gain of 6 there on first. You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle him after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
Pushing forward for 3 up to the 48. They stay on the ground. Again, it's Harris. And he's got the first down yardage there as he takes it just across midfield. So it's Buccaneer football as we welcome you back. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. Now he dumps this off over the middle. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. On first and 10, Beal. Looking downfield for Godwin. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys' 22-yard line.
Well, I can put my defensive cap on right now, and I know they're saying don't give up any big plays now. They've controlled this game throughout, and all they want to do is see it through to the end. I think they let their guard down a little bit with that last completion. Sometimes when you're trying not to give up bigger plays, you don't react as fast as you should on other throws.
To throw on second down, Beal. And he finds Howard complete. Give him a gain of 5 on the completion. And that's going to make it third down and less than a yard. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
One final shot. They'll look to throw. Eluding the pressure right. And that will be incomplete. They were going for a consolation TD, but it was not to be. And time has run out now on this game. So this one will end in a victory for the Dallas Cowboys. And they've got to feel good about this performance. I think you'd agree. Matched up against a top 5 defensive unit in the league, and they pretty much had their way.
Yeah, that was the interesting part about it, because normally when we see this defense play, they have their opportunities, and they make their plays, don't they? They knock them back on their heels. They take the ball away. They change field position. In this case, what you said is so apt. They had their way with them, took it to them, and knocked them back on their heels and surprised the heck.
From the devil got you piping hot. This up and you get screwed and chopped, no Michael Watts. When I was 10, I knew I should have been on rap a lot. Think like Jay Prince and I do more than just rap a lot. Listen, I went and got my digits up. Listen, your favorite, bruh. Listen, you don't want no trouble, cuz. The 25th, I got a meeting with the governor. That's real rap a lot, no cap a lot. I used to from Farron down to Camelot. I used to whip up in my granny's pot. She asked my friends, was I? They said, nope, he not. Benefactor's benefactor. Well, truthfully, we know you never been a factor. Well, honestly, the truth is that you've been an actor. And now your actions got them boys about to mass up. Lectures from the devil got you piping hot. This up and you get screwed and chopped, no Michael Watts. When I was 10, I knew I should have been on rap a lot. Think like Jay Prince and I do more than just rap a lot. Listen, I went and got my digits up. Listen, your favorite, bruh. You don't want no trouble, cuz. The 25th, I got a meeting with the governor. That's real rap a lot, no cap a lot. I used to from Farron down to Camelot. I used to whip up in my granny's pot. She asked my friends, was I? They said, nope, he not. The mind to a praying woman. The truth's a heavy burden and it's weighing on me. Red dog is called.
We attacking, better stand back and watch a run. Shotgun come with the option. Send big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in a slot. Trying to bend the corner, your limbs getting. That's your partner, then you swing him. All you want to do is talk, I don't need talk.
I don't hear somebody talk.
I can pull up with that.
Chewbacca. Banging my chest and my head on the locker. Feeling like Walker Flocka Fame. I put the opposition out the game. I'm out of pocket, but I rock with the game.
Taking my sativas out inside of me, so I'm like a product of power.
Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust. Kicking the dough when I come at the cut. Okay. Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust. Kicking the dough when I come at the cut. Okay.
Let's get activated,
activated.
Let's get activated, let's get activated. QB in the pocket, let it go, them bullets penetrate. When you in that field, it get real, just stay dedicated. Go.
Put me in the game, I know what to do.
Show me some.
That's another sack, cause I be running through it.
Right.
I set up the play, I'ma make a move.
Audible.
It's gonna be a blitz if I run into you.
Go. When the kick off the bomb, run it back.
Home.
Hail Mary, pray the feds don't intercept the pack. Familiar with the struggle, look, I'm coming up from scratch.
Nothing.
Huddle with my pain, then I turned it to some rats.
Celebrate.
Nothing motivate me more than when I hear the crowd roar. Chant my name in the stands, I got drums, I got bands. Same ones that was hating, buying tickets, now they fans. Call a blitz, they don't see you, they gonna tackle your little man.
Get em.
Let's get activated, let's get activated.
Activate.
Let's get activated, let's get activated. QB in the pocket, let it go, them bullets penetrate. When you in that field, it get real, just stay dedicated. Go.
Put me in the game, I know what to do.
Show me some.
That's another sack, cause I be running through it.
Right.
I set up the play, I'ma make a move.
Audible.
It's gonna be a blitz if I run into you.
Go. Pop out, treat this block like an end zone.
What?
Score. Check it. Benji calling money my ringtone.
100.
Or blue. Put her in the friend zone. She turned on more.
Ooh.
Take one for the team. I do that for my boys.
Bread. Gang.
Time ticking. I'ma give it all until the last minute. Set up the block just for my man. I bet we win it. Go hard or go home. It's survival of the fittest. Whoa.
Let's get activated, let's get activated. Let's get activated, let's get activated. QB in the pocket, let it go, them bullets penetrate. When you in that field, it get real, just stay dedicated. Go.
Put me in the game, I know what to do. That's another sack, cause I be running through it. I set up the play, I'ma make a move. It's gonna be a blitz if I run into you.
Don't want your bro, it was for show, just so you know.
We just wanna get lit, we just wanna get lit.
Chanel is the lens.
Okay.
With his friend finna get lit. I'm everything on they wish list. Which bag should I get? Which color should I pick? Any, mini, money, mo. All his money, I need mo. You big broke, gotta go. Big bird giving crow. A group of baddies coming foe. Give me money, kiss my toes. Go with your bro, it was for show. Just so you know, we just wanna get lit. 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 For show, just so you know, okay. We just wanna get lit. We just wanna get lit.
Lit.
We just wanna get lit.
Lit.
We just wanna get lit.
Stop
lit, lit, lit. Any, mini, miny, mo. All this money, I need mo. Give him a show, killing you knows and taking your bro. We just wanna get lit.
Stop.
Baby, I'm a stunner. I'm a boss. I can do what I wanna. Your last was a dude, boy. That wasn't running. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. Shot him to the moon. We ain't never going under. Hits on hits. I'm a old town slugger. White after white. We ain't never got ourselves. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. Stunned like no one stunned. She curved me back then. Came back, so I swung her. I ain't going out like no sucker. Had to let it burn like Usher. Gave a rush for an hour, Chris Tucker. You cannot mistake me for another. I had to wait my time like a buffer. I'm that did I stutter. Ball hard, might get a tick. Bought a push start for it, got a check. Drip too hard, made a. I know she won't forget that we met. She hit, I broke her down, she a wreck. They saying, Mo, you better than the rest. Who, me? I never would've guessed. Rookie, but I do it like a vet.
I like cash money, yeah, baby, I'm a stunner. I'm a boss, I can do what I wanna. Your last was a dude, boy, that wasn't running. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. Shot him to the moon, we ain't never going under. Hits, I'm a old town slugger. White after white, we ain't never got ourselves. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. I like cash money, yeah, baby, I'm a stunner. I'm a boss, I can do what I wanna. Your last was a dude, boy, that wasn't running. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. Shot him to the moon, we ain't never going under. Hits on hits, I'm a old town slugger. White after white, we ain't never got ourselves. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter.
Had to take the stairs to the top floor.
Top.
Every that slept been done for.
Done for.
Got a few bands, need a ton more. If we empty out the that's a drum roll. If we move five, hit him with the turn strikes, now that me like a real. Hold on, let me catch my breath. Hold on, let me catch my breath. We getting to the bread, it was crumbs. She loved God, turn nothing into something. She let me knock it out the park, home run. I'm a giant bear bond.
Bear bond.
She told me that the money make a. She tried more, now the mother ain't nothing.
Ain't nothing.
I've been always feeling like the one. These I'ma show how it's done.
I like cash money, yeah, baby, I'm a stunner. I'm a boss, I can do what I wanna. Your last was a dude, boy, that wasn't running. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. Shot him to the moon, we ain't never going under. Hits on hits, I'm a old town slugger. White after white, we ain't never got ourselves. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. I like cash money, yeah, baby, I'm a stunner. I'm a boss, I can do what I wanna. Your last was a dude, boy, that wasn't running. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. Shot him to the moon, we ain't never going under. Hits on hits, I'm a old town slugger. White after white, we ain't never got ourselves. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter.
Gates, who you know gon' face? I see the peak trying professional.
your little hustle, but watch it. I would hate
to hear that loud ooh.
Only religion was the moon. Made a couple million, hallelujah. Daddy was a toy. Called a homeschooler. Never did homework. I was gone home with the work, no tutor. Used to have enough. Grew up with the hustlers and the killers. Now I'm kicking it with Puffy in the villa. Chillin', click full of zombies like Thriller. Got real, about to get real. That's just how I'm feeling.